Health in Uganda, Wikipedia Audio. Health in Uganda refers to the health of the population of Uganda. As of 2013, life expectancy at birth in Uganda was 58 years, which was lower than in any other country in the East African Community except Burundi. As of 2015, the probability of a child dying before reaching age 5 was 5.5%. Total health expenditure as a percentage of gross domestic product was 7.2% in 2014. In 2015, an estimated 1.5 million people in Uganda were infected with HIV, and the HIV prevalence rate in the country was 7.2%. Uganda is one of the three countries where randomized controlled trials were conducted to determine whether voluntary male circumcision reduces transmission of HIV from women to men. Common illnesses and treatments. Uganda is home to the Uganda Virus Research Institute, a viral research facility. The leading causes of death in Uganda include communicable diseases such as HIV/AIDS, malaria, respiratory tract infections, and diarrheal disease. The risk factors most responsible for death and disability include child and maternal malnutrition, unprotected sexual activity, multiple sex partners, contaminated water, poor sanitation, and air pollution. The region has one of the highest HIV prevalence rates of 8% in the country, second only to Kampala. The region leads in poverty with 80% of households living below poverty line compared to only 20% of the country in general living in poverty. The region has the lowest per capita household expenditure of UGX 21,000 compared to UGX 30,000 of the general population. Up to 26% of people are chronically poor. The region leads in illiteracy with only 60% of the population aged 10 years and above being literate compared to 71% of the general country population. Most districts in the region lack clean piped water supply with the exception of a few town centers like Yalu, Lira, Arua, and Soratai. The pit latrine coverage ranges from 4 to 84% in some districts, the worst in the country. The region has the lowest numbers of health facilities compared to other regions of the country. Of the total 5,229 health facilities in Uganda, and 1,488 private facilities, there are only 788 health facilities in the northern region. Health facility deliveries range from 7% in Amudat, to 81% in Gulu. The region has the highest total fertility rate of 7.9 children per woman compared to the nationwide 6.1 rate. The Karamoja sub-region has high maternal mortality ratios. According to the 2001 Uganda Demographic and Health Survey, the northern region was the worst in infant child mortality indicators. For purposes of the 2011 Uganda Demographic and Health Survey, the northern region was subdivided into West Nile, North, and Karamoja, with the other three regions having 7 subdivisions, for a total of 10 subdivisions nationwide. Karamoja's under age 5 mortality rate was the worst in the country, with West Nile's rate the third worst and the North's rate the fourth best. West Nile's under age 1 mortality rate was the worst in the country, with Karamoja's rate the second worst and the North's rate the fifth best. West Nile's under 1 month mortality rate was the second worst in the country, with the North's rate tied for fourth worst and Karamoja's rate being the fourth best. Notting syndrome hit the region during the early to mid 2000s. Although the international community did not become aware of it until 2009 when the WHO and the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention first investigated it. The disease affected children aged 5-15 years, mainly in the A. coli subregion and a few in the Lango subregion. Over 3,000 confirmed cases were documented as of 2012, with Uganda having the highest number of cases in the world. The disease has profound health effects on children, families, and communities. The children who were previously healthy and growing well are observed by the parents to nod mainly at meal times initially, progressing to head nod when it is cold, etc. These children eventually develop various forms of epileptic seizures as well as disabilities such as severe malnutrition, burns, contractures, severe kyphosis, cognitive impairment, and wandering away from homes. Since the interventions began in 2012, there have been no new cases reported in the region. The exact cause of this disease has not been found, although there is strong association with onchocerciasis. Communities believe their children could have been exposed to chemicals during the war, particularly when they were displaced into internally displaced persons camps because they observed that their children became sick only when in the camps. HIV treatment in Uganda has centered on human antiretroviral therapy through task shifting or increasing the scope of health workers who can administer treatment. This shift in treatment occurred through the WHO's 2004 Integrated Management of Adult and Adolescent Illness Guide. Studies of HIV-infected adults in Uganda showed risky sexual behavior to have declined, contributing to the decline in HIV incidence. From 1990 to 2004, HIV rates declined by 70% and casual sex declined by 60%. Health communication was also listed as a potential cause of inducing behavioral changes in the Ugandan population. According to a 2015 study, impediments to reducing HIV incidence include food insecurity in rural areas and stigma against HIV counseling and testing. Uganda has the highest incidence rate of malaria in the world, with 478 people out of 1,000 population being afflicted per year. According to WHO data published in May 2014, malaria accounted for 19,869 deaths in Uganda. In 2002, the Ugandan government formalized the process of treating fevers through home-based care. Mothers who were able to better recognize symptoms of malaria took their children to a community medicine facility early in the illness. The Integrated Management of Childhood Illness allowed for better recognition of malaria's symptoms. Treatment either involved immediately taking the child to see a nearby healthcare worker or acquiring the treatment of chloroquine and SP, also known as Homepack, though kits have been found to be expired in some instances. However, resistance to Homepack emerged, and drug recommendations by the WHO changed to artemisinin combination therapy. After the midterm review in 2014 of the National Plan for Malaria Reduction and the Malaria Program Review in 2010, the National Strategy to Reduce Malaria is being redesigned. Currently, Uganda is treating malaria through distribution of insecticide-treated nets, indoor spraying of insecticides, and preventative therapy for pregnant women. The disease burden of malaria, however, remains high and is further strengthened by inadequate resources, understanding of malaria, and increased resistance to drugs. Uganda's health system is composed of health services delivered to the public sector, by private providers, and by traditional and complementary health practitioners. It also includes community-based healthcare and health promotion activities. The not-for-profit providers are run on a national and local basis and 78% are religiously based. Three main providers include the Uganda Catholic Medical Bureau, Uganda Protestant Medical Bureau, and the Uganda Muslim Medical Bureau. Non-governmental organizations have emerged as the prominent not-for-profit organizations for HIV/AIDS counseling and treatment. The for-profit providers include clinics and informal drug stores. Formal providers include medical and dental practitioners, nurses and midwives, pharmacies, and allied health professionals. Traditional providers include herbalists, spiritual healers, traditional birth attendants, hydrotherapists, etc. Uganda's health system is divided into national and district-based levels. At the national level are the national referral hospitals, regional referral hospitals, and semi-autonomous institutions including the Uganda Blood Transfusion Services, the National Medical Stores, the Uganda Public Health Laboratories and the Uganda National Health Research Organization. The aim of Uganda's health system is to deliver the national minimum health care package. Uganda runs a decentralized health system with national and district levels. The lowest rung of the district-based health system consists of village health teams. These are volunteer community health workers who deliver predominantly health education, preventive services, and simple curative services in communities. They constitute level 1 health services. The next level is Health Center 2, which is an outpatient service run by a nurse. It is intended to serve 5,000 POALI. Next in level is Health Center 3, which serves 10,000 people and provides, in addition to HC2 services, inpatient, simple diagnostic, and maternal health services. It is managed by a clinical officer. Above HC3 is the Health Center 4, run by a medical doctor and providing surgical services in addition to all the services provided at HC3. HC4 is also intended to provide blood transfusion services and comprehensive emergency obstetric care. Health infrastructure. In terms of governance, the MO is currently implementing the SIP, which is the third iteration of health sector strategies. The MO coordinates stakeholders and is responsible for planning, budgeting, policy formulation, and regulation. According to a 2006 published report, the health sector at the district and sub-district level is governed by the district health management team. The DHMT is led by the district health officer and consists of managers of various health departments in the district. The heads of health sub-districts are included on the DHMT. The DHMT oversees implementation of health services in the district, ensuring coherence with national policies. A health unit management committee composed of health staff, civil society, and community leaders is charged with linking health facility governance with community needs. In addition, the Uganda Medical Association seeks to provide programs that support the social welfare and professional interests of medical doctors in Uganda and to promote universal access to quality health and health care. However, the government's failure to improve the compensation of doctors, as well as failing to conduct a review of the supply of medicines and other equipment in health centers across the country, led to a UMA strike in November 2017, effectively paralyzing Uganda's health system. At the beginning of the 21st century, the government of Uganda began implementing a series of health sector reforms that were aimed at improving the poor health indicators prevailing at the time. A sector-wide approach was introduced in 2001 to consolidate health financing. Another demand-side reform introduced in the same year was the abolition of user fees at public health facilities, which triggered a surge in outpatient attendances across the country. Decentralization of health services began in the mid-1990s alongside wider devolution of all public administration, and was sealed in 1998 with the definition of the health sub-district. Implementation of the health sub-district concept extended into the early 2000s. To improve medicines management and availability, the government of Uganda made medicines available to private not-for-profit providers. With decentralization of health services, a poll system was instituted in which district and health facility managers were granted autonomy to procure medicines they needed in the required quantities from the national medical stores, within preset financial earmarks. The result was better availability of medicines. A comprehensive review of Uganda's health system conducted in 2011 by USAID uncovered strengths and weaknesses of the health system, organized around the six technical building blocks of health system that were defined by the WHO. In summary, the assessment found that whereas significant efforts are being implemented to qualitatively and quantitatively improve health in Uganda, more needs to be done to focus on the poor, improve engagement of the private for-profit sector, enhance efficiency, strengthen stakeholder coordination, improve service quality, and stimulate consumer-based advocacy for better health. Structure of health system. Health system reforms. The Ministry of Health also conducts annual health sector performance appraisals that assess health system performance and monitor progress in delivery of the UNMITP. The 2011 USAID report assessing Uganda's healthcare system pointed to the fact that the UNMITP often sets health sector targets and activities without an adequate analysis of the costs involved or the implementation of measures to allocate required resources appropriately. Health system performance. Health workforce. Health financing. Service delivery. Reproductive health. A number of factors affect the quality of services in Uganda, including the shortage of healthcare workers and lack of trust in them, a lack of needed treatments, high costs, and long distances to facilities. In 2009, a survey conducted of Ugandan patients indicated a decline in the performance of the public sector health services. These were indicated through comments about poor sanitation, a lack of professionals and drugs and equipment, long wait times, inadequate preventative care, a poor referral system, rude health workers, and lack of services for vulnerable populations like the poor and elderly. The quality of services affects utilization in different ways, including preventing patients from seeking out delivery services or leading them to see traditional providers, self-medicate, and decide not to seek formal care or seeing private providers. There is a significant shortage of health workers in Uganda. A human resources for health policy is in place to guide recruitment, deployment, and retention of health staff. In spite of this, shortages of health workers persist. According to a 2009 published report, there is one doctor for every 7,272 Ugandans. The related statistic is 136.810 for nurse/midwifery professionals. The shortages are worse in rural areas where 80% of the population resides, as 70% of all doctors are practicing in urban areas. There are 61 institutions that train health workers, with 5 medical colleges, 27 allied health training schools, and 29 nursing schools. Community health worker training has increased since the 2000s. The Ugandan Ministry of Health implemented the Village Health Teams training program to develop community health workers who connect rural communities to health facilities and aid in the spread of preventative knowledge about malaria, pneumonia, worm infestations, diarrhea, and neglected tropical disease. VHTs have also aided in health campaigns and disease surveillance. Non-governmental organizations, such as Health Child Uganda and Omni Med, have also been working with the Ministry of Health to train and maintain VHTs. Fertility rate and family planning. An assessment of VHT abilities led to the creation of a community health extension worker program, which involves the training of health workers for a year in all districts of the nation. Unlike VHTs, CHUs will possess elevated skills in addressing the health needs of their communities, will be based at the Health Center 2 level. The CHU program is planned for implementation in 2017 and 2018. Total public and private health expenditure per capita was $59 in 2013. Public financing for health was 4.3% of GDP in 2013, well below the target of 15% set in the 2001 Abuja Declaration. In 2006, there were 3,237 health facilities in Uganda. 71% were public entities, 21% were not-for-profit organizations, and 9% were for-profit. The doubling in public and not-for-profit facilities was primarily driven by the government's initiative to improve access to services. However, 68% of these services are located in the capital Kampala and the surrounding central region, while rural areas face a gross shortage of such facilities. According to the Uganda National Household Survey 2012/2013, the majority of those who sought healthcare first visited a private hospital or clinic or a government health center. 22% of the urban population used government health centers, while that proportion rose to 39% in the rural areas. 35% of government health centers visited by persons who fell sick were within a radius of 5 kilometers from the population. Reproductive health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being in all matters relating to the reproductive system and to its functions and processes. It implies that people have the capability to reproduce and the freedom to decide if, when, and how often to do so. Implicit in this is the right of men and women to be informed and to have access to safe, effective, affordable, and acceptable methods of family planning of their choice, as well as other methods of their choice for regulation of fertility, which are not against the law, and the right of access to health care services that will enable women to go safely through pregnancy and childbirth. RH care also includes sexual health, the purpose of which is the enhancement of life and personal relations. Uganda has the second highest fertility rate in the East African Community, behind only Burundi. According to 2014 data, a Ugandan woman, on average, gives birth to 5.8 children during her lifetime compared to 7.1 in 1969 and 6.8 in 2001. The age-specific fertility rates indicate that fertility peaks when women are aged between 20 and 24 years and then declines slowly until age 34. According to 2011 data, the fertility rate in urban areas was significantly lower than in rural areas. Based on 2012 data, 30% of married Ugandan women are using some method of contraception, with 26% using modern contraceptive methods, such as female and male sterilization, pill, intrauterine device, injectables, implants, male condom, diaphragm, and the lactational amenorrhea method. MCM were used by only 8% of married Ugandan women in 1995. There is a gap between the demand for contraception and the amount of contraception being made available. Several organizations are providing health education and contraceptive services. Antenatal care, facility deliveries, and postnatal care. Antenatal care coverage in Uganda in 2011 was almost universal, with more than 95% of women attending at least one visit. Only 48% of women, however, attended the recommended 4 visits. Deliveries in health facilities accounted for about 57% of all deliveries, far below the number of women who attend at least one ANC visit. That percentage had risen from 41% between 2006 and 2011. Only 1/3 of women received postnatal care in the first 2 days after delivery. In 2011, only 2% of mothers received a PNC checkup in the first hour for all births in 2 years before the 2011 Uganda Demographic Household Survey. Sexual Health Table, Uganda Trends and Selected SRH Indicators. Sexual health in Uganda is affected by the prevalence of HIV, sexually transmitted infections, poor health-seeking behaviors regarding STIs, violence, and female genital mutilation that affect female sexuality in isolated communities in the northeastern part of the country. As of 2015, Uganda's national HIV prevalence rate was 7.2% among adults aged 15-59 years, representing an increase from 6.7% in 2005. Prevention now includes voluntary male circumcision, although sexual behaviors among circumcised men need more understanding. Men's health. Maternal and child health. Maternal health. Issues affecting men including violence, sexually transmitted diseases, prostate cancers, infertility, HIV, and noncommunicable diseases that affect sexual performance. The latest intervention that could improve men's sexual health is male circumcision. The 2015 maternal mortality rate per 100,000 births was 343, compared to 420 in 2010 and 687 in 1990. The under 5 mortality rate per 1,000 births is 130, and the neonatal mortality as a percentage of under 5's mortality is 24. In Uganda, the number of midwives per 1,000 live births is 7, and 1 in 35 is the lifetime risk of death for pregnant women. The World Health Organization defines maternal health as the health of women during pregnancy, childbirth, and the postpartum period. According to UNICEF, Uganda's maternal mortality ratio, the annual number of deaths of women from pregnancy-related causes per 100,000 live births, was 440 from 2008 to 2012. The Millennium Development Goal for 2015 concerning the maternal mortality ratio was 131 per 100,000 births. The MDG also set a goal for all births to be attended by a skilled health professional. In rural areas, conceiving pregnant women seek the help of traditional birth attendants because of the difficulty in accessing formal health services and high transportation or treatment costs. TBAs are trusted as they embody the cultural and social life of the community. The TBAs' lack of knowledge and training and the use of traditional practices, however, have led to risky medical procedures resulting in high maternal mortality rates. Those rates also persist because of an overall low use of contraceptives, the limited capacity of health facilities to manage abortion/miscarriage complications, and the prevalence of HIV/AIDS among pregnant women. Despite malaria being one of the leading causes of morbidity in pregnant women, prevention and prophylaxis services are not well established, according to a 2013 published report. Only 47% of Ugandan women receive the recommended 4 antenatal care visits, and only 42% of births are attended by skilled health personnel. Among the poorest 20% of the population, the share of births attended by skilled health personnel was 29% in 2005/2006 compared to 77% among the wealthiest 20% of the population. Domestic violence is a key issue in reproductive health and rights. Most of the DV is gender-based. Physical violence is the most prevalent type of DV in Uganda, with one quarter of women reporting it. More than 60% of women who have ever been married have reported experiencing emotional, physical, or sexual violence from a spouse. In 2011, about 2% of women reported to have undergone female genital mutilation, a practice that is dying away in the areas where it was more frequently practiced. Northern Uganda is one of the four major administrative regions in Uganda. The region was devastated by a protracted civil war between the government of Uganda and the Lord's Resistance Army, as well as the cattle rustling conflict that lasted for 20 years. Since the war ended in 2006, the internally displaced person camps have been destroyed and people have resettled back to their former homesteads. The region, however, still has many health challenges, such as poor healthcare infrastructure and inadequate staffing at all levels, lack of access to the national electricity grid, an inability to attract and retain qualified staff, frequent stockouts in the hospitals and health facilities, emerging and re-emerging diseases such as Ebola, Nodding syndrome, onchocerciasis, and tuberculosis, proneness to malaria epidemics, the leading cause of death in the country, reintegration of former abducted child soldiers who returned home, lack of safe drinking water as most boreholes were destroyed during the war, the HIV/AIDS epidemic, poor education standards with high failure rates in primary and secondary school national examinations, and poverty. According to the 2015 Uganda Bureau of Statistics report, gender-based violence, health in the northern region, health indicators, notes.